frozen northern lights. Bulda's crystal.
Bulda's crystal.
After a long day, Kristoff, Bulda, Sven, and the trolls were relaxing by the campfire. Kristoff had come to help the trolls while Grandpappy was away. Plus, Kristoff loved being home when the northern lights were especially bright. Each night, the sky was lit up with the most beautiful hues. As the fire began to fade, one of Bulda's crystals started to flicker. "Oh," she said, "my favorite crystal is going dark." "Don't worry," said Kristoff. "You have plenty of others." "Yes," Bulda replied, "but Grandpappy gave this to me when you came to live with us. It reminds me of how perfectly you fit into our family." Kristoff was silent for a moment. Bulda had given him and Sven a home when they were very young and all alone. He was grateful to her for so much, and he wanted her to be happy. "How do you fix it?" Kristoff asked. "This crystal needs to be recharged before the current northern lights lose their color. Grandpappy knows the details, but he's not here," Bulda explained. "Sven and I can figure it out," Kristoff said. "You won't have much time. These lights have already been glowing for a week," Bulda said. "We'll leave first thing tomorrow," Kristoff said. Kristoff woke early. "Maybe searching for other natural crystals is a good start," he said to Sven. He remembered that Anna and Elsa had an extensive collection of books and maps at the castle. So they set off to Arendelle to ask their friends for help. Kristoff found Anna, Elsa, and Olaf having tea in the library. Everyone was thrilled to see him, especially Olaf. Kristoff quickly explained that he needed to recharge Bulda's crystal. "I know one of these old books led your family to the trolls when Anna was little, and I was hoping that now it could lead me where I need to go," he said. Elsa knew exactly which book Kristoff was referring to. "This chapter is about crystals," Elsa said as she opened the large volume. "Troll crystals can be recharged where lights wake the sky, where sky touches the earth, and where waters run long," Elsa read aloud. "Lights that wake the sky could be the northern lights," said Anna. "A mountaintop could be where the sky touches the earth," said Kristoff. "And there's a long, narrow fjord by a plodding mountain," said Anna. "I bet that's where waters run long." They decided to head to the peak of a plodding mountain. It was a full day's journey from Arendelle, so there was no time to waste. The friends quickly packed food, blankets, and a map, then set out on their quest. The group had been hiking all morning and eventually arrived at the top of a steep cliff. Kristoff looked over the side, searching for a trail. According to the map, we'll have to climb down the other side, Anna said. There's no way around. Everyone peeked over the cliff. Anna quickly grabbed a rope and rushed down the mountain before anyone else had a chance to prepare. Kristoff followed Anna's lead. Climbing down was harder than he thought. He was glad Anna had recently learned to rock climb, but he was worried about the others. I have an easier way, Elsa said. With a wave, Elsa used her icy magic to create an ice slide down the side of the cliff. Then she, Olaf, and Sven slid past Kristoff and Anna. Wee-hee! Olaf laughed. The ice slide was fun, but it wasn't the shortcut they were hoping for. After hours of walking and climbing, the friends finally reached the top of a plodding mountain. To their surprise, there was nothing special on the summit. Anna looked around, puzzled. Do you think we went to the wrong mountain? She asked. The sun was beginning to set, so the group decided to stop for the night. Maybe we'll have better luck in the morning, Kristoff said. As it got darker, the friends set up camp under a rock overhang. The group settled into their blankets, and Kristoff taught them a new song. As they listened, ribbons of color spread across the night sky. And suddenly, crystals hidden within the mountain began to turn bright. I've never seen rocks glow before, said Olaf. Kristoff immediately stopped singing. Glowing rocks? He exclaimed. Where? Everyone got up and gazed at a crack in the overhang behind them. Could those be crystals? Asked Elsa. Sven nudged everyone out of the way and hit the rock with his antlers. Crack! He created a wedge, and a few crystals spilled out, but the crystals stopped glowing as they shook loose from a larger rock. Maybe I can help, Elsa suggested. She waved her hands, summoning her powers. Ice crept into the cracks, and as the rock froze, the cracks were forced wider apart. Anna was drawn toward the glow. Perhaps if we remove them carefully, the crystals will stay bright, she said. Uh-oh, Elsa said. The lights in the sky are starting to fade, and the crystals in the rock are too. Anna thought for a moment. Perhaps we're going about this the wrong way, she said. The crystals are glowing inside the mountain. So, if we put Bulda's crystal inside, maybe it will glow too. As Anna held Bulda's crystal up to the crystals inside the wall, a magical spark passed between them. Anna thought she'd saved the day, but when she removed her hand from the rock, Bulda's crystal was still dark. What happened? Asked Anna. I thought we completed the quest. After a short night's sleep and out of time and ideas, the group headed home, feeling discouraged. They hadn't been able to recharge Bulda's crystal. Still, they knew they tried their best, and everyone had to admit it had been an adventure. When they returned to Troll Valley, Bulda greeted them with hugs. Welcome back, she said. But Kristoff was disappointed. We weren't able to recharge your crystal, he admitted. I'm so sorry. Well, Bulda said, crystals can be finicky. Let's take a look. As Anna placed the stone in Bulda's hands, the crystal began to glow brightly. You did it, said Bulda. We did? Kristoff asked. Oh, Kristoff, you underestimate your own magic. When you work together, support one another, and have fun, anything is possible, Bulda explained. By making the journey, you did something good for someone you love. It has given the crystal a reason to glow. Kristoff smiled. I'm glad we could help.
Thank you for watching our videos, Eve.
By making the journey, you did something good for someone you love. It has given the crystal a reason to glow. Kristoff smiled. I'm glad we could help.